Great. All right. So we, I forgot to push the record button. We lost game one. We were being constantly punched. So this is. This has so much of our power, and it has a removal spell. It's hard to ignore. Next turn, we get to Heliod, and then Authority of the Councils gets to go nuts and turn Speaker of the Heaven into a weird-looking pride mate. Before they stomp it. One, two, three, four. Close. This getting stomped is no good. Locus. Okay. We can Baffling End that. Worth Baffling Ending. If we Baffling End and then give this, we can get it out of stomp range. So we bury that. We give this lifelink, swing for 8. All creatures they bring in are tap. And they're probably not going to get to 7 loyalty. Oh, this is a great place to be. Okay, let's go. Let's go. We don't care about our graveyard. Take it. Speaking of life gain. Yes. Oh, Heliod. So good. Gotta stop keeping bad hands. Hello, friend? There we go. Good hand, good hand, good hand, good hand, good hand, good hand. Pretty good. Removal, removal, Heliod, Daxos, a curve. Just need a land. Famous last words. Six. Backland. I think we still Daxos. It's the mana efficient. Plus this blocks BTEs really well. Oh wait. Oh yeah, it does. Legion's Landing is here. How many did you draw? Okay, good. Just one. having three removal spells plus Heliod against Ghoul is going to be the nuts. Great. But they are not developing their board, so I will take it. Add that life total. Alright, next turn is Heliod. We get to go for the races after that. Not the fastest start from Ghoul I've ever seen. I suppose we could have blocked. Nah, that's... Don't be dumb. No, this is better. Actually, you know what? With full information, this is a Coco. Authority, dropping everything in, tap. It's alright. Maybe they'll whiff and we still get to swing in for free. Or they get 8 power in play. And you know what, if we had cast this, then they would have just done it in response. Alright, taking 10. Ouch. Follow up. Other giant. Yeah. Land would be amazing. Okay, not a land, still good. We could Pride Mate and Authority of the Consoles, but I don't think we can take that much damage is the deal. If I take this, I get to attack. I mean, I'm taking a 4-power thing anyways. Now this can block a BTE. If we can just stay alive 2 more turns and draw another land. If this dies, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, can't have this not be a creature. Well, we have stuff afterwards. I mean, this is Embercleave, right? You don't play a Gruul and not have that. So if they Embercleave this, it's 10, 12, and then this dies. If they Embercleave this, it's 5, 9, 10, 11. Not dead. The bad news too is Baffling End doesn't stop. Never leave afterwards. Lifelink 3, 6, go to 8. Give this lifelink 8. Hmm. Then we, Baffling End, the Bone Crusher, they're just swinging in for 6. Yeah, and I'm Baffling End. Five, 8, 10, 11. This is 7, they're at 10. I can hold this back and block the BTE. Oh yeah. Let's make this out of range. Let's make... So they can't play blockers. We're coming in for a lot. Ember Cleaving this doesn't really do it, and they don't have enough mana to Desert Oasis, Heshep Oasis it, and Ember Cleave. Yeah. They're 1 mana short of that. Their land. They can shoot me down to 6, but oh yeah, I need to do that thinking beforehand. I'm Robbie Wong, thanks for watching. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe. Feeling pretty good. Those are solid numbers.